Kalau kamu bicara pelan-pelan, saya mengerti. Kamu.
Oke. Hello everyone, welcome back to Lee Afifa Channel. Bagi kalian yang baru bergabung di channel aku, jangan lupa untuk klik tombol like, comment, dan juga subscribe. Oke okay guys, it's been a long time no see. Sudah lama sekali ya tidak berjumpa. Dan seperti biasa, Miss akan memberikan materi pelajaran untuk kalian semua sebagai penunjang ya dalam belajar bahasa Inggris. Nah, di segmen kali ini segmen yang spesial nih, karena saya akan berkolaborasi dengan Mr. Rhode. Beliau merupakan seorang native speaker yang berasal dari England atau Britania Raya. Beliau akan memberikan materi pelajaran tentang present perfect tense, bagaimana penggunaan been dan juga gone. Nah, kemarin kita sempat belajar present perfect tense bersama-sama di channel Miss ini ya, dan linknya ada di atas ini. Jika adik-adik belum memahami apa itu present perfect tense, boleh dilihat lagi ya materinya. Dan setelah itu baru kembali ke video ini untuk mencari tahu lebih lanjut nih, apa sih present perfect tense tersebut. Oke okay guys, kita langsung saja ke pembahasan kita bersama Mr. Rhode. Oke, okay, I forgot something. Jangan lupa untuk berkunjung ke channelnya Mr. Rhode juga ya, di Pak Guru Rhode. Linknya ada di description box dan juga di comment pinned. Di sana link video YouTube beliau itu ada di sana. Tetapi tonton dulu videonya sampai akhir ya, karena Miss akan memberitahu bagaimana sih cara mengkontak Mr. Rhode ini jika kita ingin belajar bahasa Inggris lebih lanjut. Oke guys, kita langsung sajalah ke materinya ya. Check this out.
Leah, nice to see you at last.
Hi sir, nice to see you too.
Hey, don't call me sir, call me Rhode. I'll tell you why.
Okay.
To be a sir, you have to go to the Queen of England, Queen Elizabeth, and she takes a huge sword and she knights you and say, arise.
Okay.
So I'm not a sir because
I saw that moment sometimes at the movies. I saw it.
I know.
Okay, then I will call you Mr. Rhode then.
Yeah, whatever. Pat Rhode, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, whatever. Many people just call me Rod. It's whatever you want is fine. I can call you Leah, right?
Yes, of course. Just call me Leah.
Great. To you, the audience, my lovely audience, and also to Leah's audience, because for everybody who's watching, actually, Leah has her own channel, been around for at least a year. And for me, as you know, we're a new channel. We've only been going for around a month. Our theme is Belajar and Tatawa. So, Leah, maybe you can just translate that for your viewers.
Oh, yeah, guys. Jadi, Mr. Rhode ini baru memulai channel YouTube sekitar 1 bulan lalu. Dan beliau ini mengangkat tema Belajar dan Tertawa. Jadi, kita semua di sini bisa belajar bahasa Inggris sambil tertawa bersama. Jadi, tidak terpaku dengan hanya belajar saja, tapi juga sambil ngobrol santai.
So, Leah, thank you very much. Can you just tell our viewers in English and Bahasa, maybe 1 minute just about your background? And I wanted to share with my viewers, Leah is from, let me think, Sumatra, right? You're from Sumatra.
Oh, yes.
Or in Bahasa, Sumatera, right?
Okay, right.
Where you're from, the name of your name of your school and so on, yeah?
Okay, okay, guys. Nice to meet you, to Mr. Rhode's viewers. Dan perkenalkan, my name is Leah. I came from Bengkulu di Sumatera. I am an English teacher in the rural. Saya ini seorang guru bahasa Inggris di sebuah daerah, di daerah Bengkulu. Saya merupakan seorang guru bahasa Inggris madrasah. Dan tujuan saya di sini untuk berkolaborasi dengan Mr. Rhode. Yeah. Supaya kita bisa belajar bahasa Inggris bersama-sama dengan santai dan juga menyenangkan.
Excellent.
I think that's all.
Yeah, just one very quickly so the readers know, the audience knows my background.
Oh yes.
I teach PhD. I work with PhD mm-hmm. students all over the world, including Indonesians. ST, you call STIGA, PhD, all over the world. and also masters, S2, those two. S2, S3, I coach and help students all over the world with their thesis and dissertations. I also work with IELTS, TOEFL, GMAT, SAT, GRE, all of that stuff I work with as well. And of course, this is my fun. This is what I do for fun, what I love doing. I've just started. This is the teaching where I can teach ordinary Indonesians who have no English, who can't speak English, they want to learn English. Hello, we're here. People like Ia and me, we're here to help you. You want to learn English?
That's right.
It's for free, and we're here to help you. Ia, just translate it very quickly. Thank you.
Okay. Jadi guys, Mr. Broad ini sekarang profesinya adalah mengajar magister dan juga doktoral. Beliau ini juga merupakan seorang pengajar dari IELTS, kemudian TOEFL, dan GMAT, dan lain sebagainya. Jadi siapapun yang mau belajar bahasa Inggris bersama Mr. Broad itu sangat di persilakan karena beliau sangat welcome dengan orang-orang yang ingin belajar.
That's right. And one more thing, let me start the lesson. One more thing is that for all my viewers, if you want to visit Leah's website, okay, oh sorry, her channel, I'm going to put the link to this in the comments and also on the description. So on the description will be a link to her channel and also in the comment as well. It'll be pinned to the top of the comment, so it'll never always stay there. You can actually see exactly who she is and her channel as well. And I think she will do the same for me as well. So her viewers can also see who we are. Is that right, Leah?
Of course. Yes, right.
Translate that quickly, Leah.
Okay, jadi siapapun yang mau belajar ke Mr. Rod itu bisa visit channel beliau itu di Pak Guru Rod, right sir?
Yes.
Pak Guru Rod. Yes. Nama channelnya adalah Pak Guru Rod. Jadi silakan datang ke channel beliau dan linknya ada di description box dan juga ada di comment pinned di bawah ini ya. Jadi jangan ragu-ragu untuk datang ke channel beliau.
Great, thanks Leah, thank you so much. Okay, today we're going to study 5 English words.
Okay.
Been, gone, just, already, and yet. Let's repeat it one more time. Been and gone, just, already, and yet. They're all words we use in, guess what? In present perfect. Why do we use present? Okay, Leah, why do we use present perfect? What's the reason?
We use present perfect when the action already happened, just happened, or happened sometimes before now.
Correct. Exactly. So whatever things that have happened in the past are still relevant, still important now. Right?
Okay.
So if I say I've been to Bali, it means I've been there and I still have the experience. I still remember. Still important. It's still relevant. Right? So basically, present perfect is taking the past and the present. Mm-hmm. We have 3 times. Yes. Past, present, future. What the present perfect does is take the past and the present and put them together. It's now one time zone.
Oh.
Everything in the past is relevant or important or has some meaning to the now. That's all. It's that easy. So if I say if I say I went to Bali, you could say, who cares? So what? Right? Like this. Who cares? Not important. If I say I have been to Bali, it means, oh, really? It's kind of important, right? That's the difference between verb 2, simple past, and present perfect, right?
Okay, right.
Right. Uh-uh. Okay, so we're going to look first at been and gone. A lot of people ask about this. So... Leah, why do we use what's the reason for using been and gone?
We use gone when we're not in that place, like for example, like what? Oh, Leah is not here. Leah gone to Jakarta on holiday.
Yeah, she's gone. She's still there. She is still there, right?
Oh, okay. She's still there.
She hasn't come back. Been, she's gone there and come back, right?
Okay, right.
So, you imagine going on a train. You know, correct? Is it Greta? Train?
Oh, motorcycle?
No, train. You know, Greta. Train.
Oh, yes, I know.
Right? Mm. You go on a train, you buy a ticket one way, That's gone. You buy that's two-way gone. Ticket, two-ticket return. That's gone, been, and gone. All right, gone, and then been.
Oh, okay.
So you come back. So been is when you come back. You've gone, and you come back. Gone, you're still there. Been, you've gone there, and you come back.
Okay. May I translate this for our viewers?
Please.
Okay. Jadi guys, di sini kita belajar dua kata dulu nih. Ada gone sama been. Nah, perbedaannya kalau gone itu kita pergi ke suatu tempat dan kita belum kembali. Contohnya Lia pergi ke Jakarta. Jadi si Lia masih di Jakarta.
Yeah.
Kemudian kalau misalnya been, Lia kemarin ke Jakarta dan hari ini sudah kembali. Berarti kalau been, si Lia sudah balik lagi ke tempat semula. Seperti
Lia, silakan. Bicara, plan, saya pusing. Cepat.
Okay, I'm so sorry.
It's okay. If you,
okay.
Kalau kamu bicara, plan, saya mengerti. Kamu,
okay.
I'm sorry.
Okay,
it's okay. Enggak apa-apa. It doesn't matter, right? Okay, so let's do a couple examples. If I say, I can say, oh, Lia is on holiday. Why? Oh, she's gone to, I don't know, she's gone to where? She's gone to Padang, right? She's gone to Padang. She's still there, right? Yes?
Right.
So here's another one. Hello, can you make another one for me? Just make another example.
Okay, like okay, Mr. Rod, where is Alex?
Oh, he's gone to Jakarta.
Oh, he's gone to Jakarta. Yes, it means
right. He's Alex still there. Hasn't not returned. Come back.
Yes.
He's still there. Tidak kembali. Right.
Belum kembali berarti. Yeah.
Dia's another example. Hello, I've just been to the shops.
Yes.
I bought a lot of things. Look at the things I bought. I bought this. I bought so many things. I have been. It means I've gone there and come back, right?
Right. Yeah. Jadi guys, kalau been itu pergi dan sudah kembali.
Very good. Yeah, thank you. That's good. another one. Yui. Yui isn't here. Where's Yui? She's not here. Where is she? She's not here. Oh, she's gone to the shop. Oh, okay. Did you hear that?
Oh yeah. Yes, I heard that.
She's
contohnya
gone.
Yang lain begini,
she's
guys.
Not here. She's gone to the shop.
Si Yui ini kemana nih?
Yeah.
Jadi Mr. Rod bilang Yui has gone to the shop.
Yes, she's not here.
Si Yui tidak di sini. Si Yui-nya itu pergi ke shop. Jadi dia lagi belanja. Dan belum balik berarti.
My friend, his name is Bagus. He's, right? He's gone out. He has gone out. He's not here. But, tetapi, he will be back in half an hour. Okay.
Okay. Contoh lain nih, Mr. Rod punya teman namanya Bagus. Bagus sedang pergi. Gone, artinya tidak di tempat. Tetapi si Bagus akan pulang lagi setelah 1.5 jam.
Yeah, that's right. And then when he comes back, then we can say he has been. Yeah, he has been there.
Okay.
Right? He's come back, right?
Right. Gone. Jadi kalau misalnya, kalau si Bagus sudah balik ke sini, yang gone tadi kita ubah menjadi been berarti bukan he has gone tapi he has been.
Very good. Okay, let's do one more. Lia, are you going to the bank, BCR Bank? You say, no, I have already been to the bank. Already, udah, I've been.
Okay, I've been already.
To the bank.
Oh, artinya berarti.
Have you been to the bank? You say, yeah, are you, I say, are you going to the bank? You say, I have already been there. Sudah
berarti sudah pergi ke banknya. Nah, kalau yang pakai already itu berarti sudah. Seperti tadi Mr. Rod bertanya nih, Lia, apakah kamu sudah pergi ke bank? Dan Silia menjawab, iya, saya sudah pergi ke bank tersebut, kayak gitu. I already been, berarti sudah pergi dan sudah kembali.
Yeah, that's very good. That's correct. Okay, we were going to spend some time on talking about yet, already, yes. But I think today, because the time is getting short, I will just explain what they mean, and then the next lesson, we can then go into different examples of already and just. I think already is udah, already, yeah? And then if we say yet, it means belum, right?
Belum, oh yes, yet, belum.
But just, I'm not sure, it's just happened. 1 minute ago, how do we say it in Bahasa? It's just happened.
Barusan.
Oh, baru what?
Barusan.
Barusan, excellent. Yes. Bahasa, great. All right. You're a good teacher.
Barusan itu. Just happened. Barusan berarti.
Yeah. Barusan, okay. Yeah, yes. Just. So, okay, we're just explaining now. And the next lesson, we're going to go into lots of different examples of just, already, and yet. Yeah. So just is yes, barusan. And then already, it's happened already. What is that already?
Already, sudah berarti, ya, telah,
yeah,
sudah.
Exactly. And then, yet, I think it's belum, right? Belum, yet.
Yes, belum. Yet means belum.
Great, that's excellent. Okay, so we've gone through 5 different words today. We're studying some present perfect. We now know that in present perfect is about bringing the past, yang lalu, and now sekarang together. It's one time frame. So everything happened in the past is still relevant, still meaning, still important sekarang. Do you want to just remember?
Okay. Jadi guys, present perfect itu adalah menyatukan masa lalu, simple past, dan juga masa kini, simple present tense. Itu kita gabungkan jadi satu. Nah, berarti di masa lalu itu masih ada relevansinya sama masa kini. Maksudnya masih berhubungan dengan masa kini. Itulah yang dimaksud dengan present perfect tense.
Yeah, present perfect. Good. Leah, thank you so much for joining me today. I'm very honored you're here.
Oh, me too.
You're a lovely lady. You're very smart. I can see why you have many, many students and many, many followers.
See
why.
Okay, sir. You too. You are a lovely teacher, just like your... Who's your student's name? Your IELTS students?
Oh, the one you see, she's often does the video with me. Her name is Fadi. Her name is Fadia. Fadia.
Fadia.
Yeah.
Okay, Fadia was right. You are a good teacher.
Thank you so much. You're very kind. Actually, for all the viewers, the reason why Fadi is not here this week is because she has gone out to do research for her university in beekeeping. She's interviewing 36 beekeepers, two park rangers, and 2 farmers. She's interviewing for her university research. Maybe you can just explain in Bahasa,
Okay, jadi guys, Mr. Roth ini punya student, punya siswa namanya Mbak Fadia. Nah, Mbak Fadia ini salah satu murid IELTS-nya Mr. Roth. Dan dalam 2 minggu, beliau itu bisa membantu Mbak Fadia mencapai skor IELTS 7,5. Wow. Jadi kalau kalian mau belajar IELTS, bisa langsung ke Mr. Roth. Dan sekarang Mbak Fadia lagi sibuk, research untuk penelitian tentang lebah di suatu daerah di Bandung.
Yeah, she was my friend. She was my student, and now she's my friend. Perfect, right?
Oh yes, of course. That's perfect.
All right. To all you beautiful viewers, you the audience, thank you so much. And sampai jumpa lagi. See you again, Leah.
Okay, guys. Mungkin sampai sini dulu ya. Ini sesi satunya nih. Sesi satunya kita udah belajar tentang gone dan juga been. Nanti di next video kita akan lanjut lagi membahas already, kemudian yet, dan juga apa satu lagi tadi ya?
Yet, already,
just. Okay, yet, already, dan just kita akan bahas di sesi selanjutnya. Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Road.
Thank you, Leah. Bye-bye.
Yeah, bye. See you.
Okay guys, I think that's all for today. Jangan lupa untuk subscribe, comment, and share so that this video can be useful for many people. Jangan lupa untuk mampir juga ke channelnya Mr. Road ya, di Pak Guru Road, di mana link dari YouTube-nya beliau ini ada di description box dan juga ada di comment pinned. Okay guys, I'll see you around.